This is the Reality Radio Network on Telstar 5 Transponder 5 and on the internet at realityradionetwork.com.
And now, Sherry Schreiner Live.
Everybody, and welcome to the show. I'm Sherry Schreiner. Temple 1, July 4th, Deep Impact. What was it really? Well, back then I said it was an alien carrier, and that's exactly what it was. If you look at years ago when Hill Bob came and that call talk committed suicide in the hopes of catching a ride with them, folks, you don't catch a ride with a block of ice. Now, these so-called comets are not what they are, telling you that they are. Most of them are ships, carriers of alien beings, and not blocks of ice. If you want to be lied to, listen to NASA. I've always said that. Never a straight answer, NASA. They're to always give the public disinformation. So don't listen to them. You know, whenever you hear something coming out of NASA's mouth, they're lying. And so ask yourself, what's the real story? What's the real story behind what they're trying to shove down your throat? Because they're never telling you the truth about anything. Prophet Yeehaw, Ramon Watkins, most of you know, he goes around calling himself Prophet Yahweh. I call him Prophet Yeehaw, and he declared on his website that the nuke hit on the comet was an act of war. And you know what? To the aliens, it would be. You know, NASA was attempting to destroy an alien ship headed toward Earth. These things, by their outward appearances, may take on different forms, such as ice on its outward appearance, because deep space is cold, and it's freezing. But inside they are hollow, and this is where the real inhabitants are, inside these comets and carriers headed to Earth. As far as the Discovery Shuttle goes, I posted on my blog, actually just wondering aloud if the Discovery Shuttle would be blasted out of the sky like the Columbian Challenger were by the Russians, and I hadn't posted a code on it, just relaying some thoughts I had. And an hour or two after posting my blog, the launch itself was canceled. And if you read the writings from the New Age crowd, it was canceled for security reasons. If you believe in coincidences, that's your prerogative, but I've heard, and I do believe, they are watching everything I say online very closely and canceled the launch because of my blog posting. You know, you can laugh about what I'm telling you, but it all comes out in the wash later, and folks, I'm always standing when the BS falls around me. I'm still researching this whole Discovery Shuttle issue, and what I'm finding, despite some of my postings in my blog this week, and the fact that they were bringing a beast prophet to Earth, it appears they were trying to terminate a portal opening so they couldn't come to Earth. Some of the findings I found in the code, and I'm going to post the code tonight, our termination gateway, that was their main reason for going up, withheld prevention, Matria, Mars, gateway, Schreiner declaration, correctness, Mars, slowed, delayed. And basically what this means, folks, is that the whole mission of this Discovery Shuttle was to go up to Mars and close some kind of gateway. It was a termination of a gateway. It was their project. It was George Bush who canceled the launch, probably fearing that the Russians would blow it out of the sky. And I had no information that they would. I was just musing over the fact, would they? So some people say we bought time with it. I don't think so. I mean, we're just trading off, folks, one horrible regime putting us in slavery and death for another one. They're just fighting it out amongst themselves. We're always going to be stuck in the center here. But it reveals a lot to me, especially after having spent so much time in the Mars Codes several years ago, where I learned that this Mavis that Nostradamus talks about would come from Mars is Maitreya Mavis. You know, I've wondered that a lot on this show before. Is Maitreya this Mavis Nostradamus was talking about? And even just all the work I've done on this Maitreya, I don't believe he's permanent. I think he's going to come and go. He very well could fit the role of Mavis, very well, because he also is from the Mars area, despite what he tells the New Age crowd. And we know that they also do have a big base in Belém, Brazil, in the mountains there. And so something's going on, and so I did some research. Actually, my assistant, Rhonda, did some research and sent me some articles on the Lion's Gate, and we found this gate that they've been talking about, and it was in the New Age writings, and it's referring to a Lion's Gate, and I'm going to get into that here in a few minutes. But there is actually a gate opening, gate significance for the month of March, and surprise, surprise, they scheduled a shuttle launch. And so going to get back into that, but what I have seen and what I'm trying to connect is that this whole Las Vegas UFO event that Raymond Watkins, Prophet Yeehaw, was going around touting, he was going to summon a UFO down from the sky for 2 days and hover over Las Vegas, and it didn't happen, and if you'll notice, it was canceled right after the Discover shuttle was canceled. So they kind of, it makes you wonder what was going on, and were they hand in hand. And it does come up in the same code with the Discover Shuttle, this whole thing about Las Vegas being a meat market for the meat lockers. And, you know, we warned, especially on my show Aliens in the News, Peggy Kane and I spent two shows warning about how these people were being baited to go out and meet these UFOs, and they would just be taken and used for meat. I mean, these aliens are coming and using humans for food. And I've been warning about that, and I'm going to continue warning about that. And if you saw the movie War of the Worlds, which I just saw over the weekend, and some of the things I saw in there are just real eyebrow-raising. I didn't care for the movie itself. I didn't care for the whole Tom Cruise storyline thing. I think it should have been more like a government military thing against the aliens. And, of course, they come with these machines, and that kind of killed the whole thing. But what I thought was really interesting was that several months ago I'd had a dream where I was being chased by a UFO, and it had this long tube, and it was sucking people up, and this thing was chasing me, trying to suck me up with this tube. And then you watch this movie, War of the Worlds, and they had the same thing. They had these big machines, and these hoses would come down and suck people up. And so it's like, well, one of the things that raised my eyebrows on it. But basically, folks, what's going on is that we're in the middle of a space war. We're in space wars. The Greys and Reptilians here are trying to prevent the Anunnaki from coming to Earth and taking over. The Greys and Reptilians are working through humans, through NASA and the government here, to accomplish their own agenda of taking over Earth for themselves. In retrospect, both classes are normally slaves to the Annex, and for now are in their own mutiny and war against them to conquer and control the Earth for themselves. The Anunnaki are returning to Earth by the millions in various ways. They have various ships and carriers, Nibiru being one of them, as well as the various comets heading this way. I dare call them comets. Most of them are just some kind of anomalous objects. They're not really comets. They're just anomalous objects. But NASA likes to call them comets, and so that's the lingo. These Anak that are coming are 9 to 11 feet tall giants. Picture several hundred million Goliaths on the Earth, because that's what I've seen for our future and visions. And from what the Most High has shown me himself about what's coming, the tall Greys and Reptilians won't be able to beat them, although they will be put Earth in the middle of complete chaos and destruction as a result of their feud and war against them. Despite their attempts through NASA and our government to stop them, the Anak will arrive here and subdue the Earth while Satan rules as the Antichrist. And folks,